Welcome to Community Concerts at Seconds 35th season of world-class music, offered free to all. Serving our hometown of Baltimore and the wider region through live and virtual events, the series is presented at Second Presbyterian Church and was founded by Margaret Budd in 1987. Community Concerts at Second is an independent, nonprofit organization, and our mission is to enrich our community by providing free professional musical experiences of lasting artistic value. Today's concert is made possible by you, our audience, and our donors. Since we do not charge admission to our concerts, we rely upon contributions from you, our audience. Please consider making a contribution to the concert series online at cc2nd.org or by texting cc2 to the number 44321. We thank you for your attention and your support, and we hope you enjoy today's concert.
Going. Hi. Thank you all so much for coming. I could not be more thrilled to see an in-person audience here at Second Presbyterian Church for Community Concerts at Seconds Chamber Music by Candlelight series. Thank you so much for coming. My name is Chris Shannon. I'm the Managing Director of Community Concerts at Second. And I am just so thankful that we're back in person. We do have an online audience as well, as you all notice. And so we have people watching on YouTube also. Thanks to those watching at home, and thanks to you all watching here. We are so thankful to you all for joining us this evening to enjoy another world-class performance, free to all. Our series would not exist without you, okay? You are Community Concerts at Second. We wouldn't exist if we didn't have an audience, okay? So I really want to thank you for that, and we really also thank you for your very, very generous support you provided us this year. If you've made a gift to the series already, thank you so very much. If you have not made a gift to the series yet this year, please consider making a donation at the doors in the front and the back as you leave today. I will note that there is no intermission today. There are three selections on today's concert. The first selection is a replacement for a piece. The performers were ill and could not attend today. They're okay, but we do have a wonderful replacement, a Dvorak piece. In addition to you all, we have another thank you to send out to the wonderful congregation here at Second Presbyterian Church. They've been hosting this series for 35 years, and it's been free to all the entire time. So I want to thank anyone here who's from that congregation, and of course, everyone who's not here, but who's been so generous to the series. Before we begin today's concert, I do want to focus a little bit on the next couple concerts. In particular, March 20th is a big event for us. We were able to engage an artist named Natalie Joachim. She is a Haitian artist, and she's presenting a project called Femmes d'Haïti. That means women of Haiti. She's working with Spectral Quartet. Spectral Quartet is a Grammy-nominated quartet. They've been nominated for 4 Grammys in their history. They're one of the most acclaimed string quartets in the country. And this will be their last tour. They're actually, you know, breaking up at the end of this year, so this is the last time to see them. We've got 290 people registered for that concert already. So if you have not registered, I would encourage you to go to our website and fill out the little form and register. We just need to know if we're going to exceed our capacity. We're not going to be checking for tickets or anything, but we need to know if we, you know, are going to have too many people, okay? So please go ahead and register for that concert. If you're here from a retirement center, you probably are already registered. Finally, I just want to say thanks to all those who've donated this year. Thanks to those who are attending. And now, at this point, I would like everyone to take a moment to silence their phones. I will do so as well. And I want to take a moment to welcome the fine musicians from the Baltimore Symphony.
Good evening, everyone. Glad to see you all here, and thank you so much for coming to the concert tonight. I just wanted to give a few words about the piece we're about to play. It's by Antonin Dvorak. It's titled Miniatures, and it's for two violins and viola, as you can see. It was written actually right after another piece for the same ensemble called Terzetto. I actually played that a few years ago on this series. And that was a slightly more difficult piece. This one's a little simpler, and that was for a specific reason. Dvorak had a roommate at the time, and he was an amateur violinist. And his friend, Dvorak's friend from the orchestra he played in, was teaching this student, and the terzetto was a little bit too difficult for him to play well. So Dvorak decided to write this piece that uses a little bit simpler melodies, and gives a beautiful sound to everybody, but without being too difficult. And so it was later written, probably in the more famous arrangement for violin and piano, and that's titled Romantic Pieces. So they're actually the same violin part for both. So it does use simple melodies, but the harmony underneath has all the highlights of Dvorak's specialty in that area, so you'll hear all the beautiful colors he's able to develop throughout each melody. And then the final movement, titled Elegy, is probably the most deeply emotional of the movements. And we wanted to dedicate that to Jeremiah Pollitt, who is the sexton here. And so I hope that we can all think of him while we're playing the last movement. So thank you for coming tonight.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. My name is Skylar Jackson. I play bassoon. I am joined by my colleagues Christine Murphy on flute and Vitor Trindade on clarinet. I'm just so happy to see you all live here. And thank you to our audience at home for tuning in to the live stream. I want to talk about the piece we're going to play tonight by a really remarkable person named Rosie Wertheim. I have some notes because I don't want to forget anything. She's quite remarkable. This trio is a piece that she wrote while she was in hiding during World War II. So that's just a little taste of what I'll get to at the end. But Rosie was born in Amsterdam. She was one of the first Dutch women to receive a degree in music composition. And she came from a wealthy family that was very philanthropic, and they believed that they should use their wealth to help those less fortunate than themselves. And her grandfather, actually, there's a fountain dedicated to him and his philanthropy in Amsterdam, which you can still see today. So what I wanted to say is that's really remarkable about this person is that during World War II, she went into hiding. She was Jewish. She was a female, unmarried, feminist, and a composer. So truly targeted by the regime at the time. And she hid her friends in her home, and they gave recitals. And this piece was written in 1942. We can assume that it was played at one of those recitals in her home while they were in hiding. She had a wonderful sense of humor. She made light of the terrible situation that she was in. And I think you'll hear the vast emotion and character that this human being conveyed, I think at all times, probably, in her life. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you. Thank you. welcome to everybody again. This is the last piece of the program, Robert Schumann's Piano Quartet. For those of you who don't know the piece, you're in for a treat, because as we were discussing among us, this probably is in the top five of greatest pieces ever written for any instrument ever, forever. There's a reason for that, though. It's not just because of its beautiful melodies. It's not because of its incredible drive. It's not because of the rather unusual combination. When Schumann wrote this piece in 1847, there had been very few examples of piano quartets, mainly by Mozart and Beethoven, and they almost all of these examples were a pairings between piano versus strings or piano with accompaniment of strings. So Robert Schumann actually took that and made it in a way that is one of the most organic works you would ever hear, in which every combination possible between these four instruments is broadcasted by the composer. One little thing that is sort of a really interesting trivia, Robert Schumann wrote an optional scordatura at the end of the third movement. For those of you who don't know, the word scordatura literally means detune or retune for the cello. So many of my colleagues don't do that because they say it's not worth retuning the whole instrument to play just one note. But if you point your attention towards the end of the third movement, you're going to hear that I'm actually playing that D-tuned note. So it's my lowest string is C, and I tune it back, or I tune it down to a B flat, something that is rather unusual sonority, sort of almost in the double bass realm. And then I'll continue playing with that detuned string. So just wish me luck with that. Just keep me in your prayers, your thoughts, whatever you are. It is one of the most exciting moments for me. But again, this is Robert Schumann's Piano Quartet.
Thank you. you.